In the Hisui region, there are Pokémon that are blessed with a mysterious power. We don't know what this mysterious power is at the moment, but I'm sure that we will eventually find out. However, in this video, we are going to be talking about the special Pokémon that have received this blessing. First, let's look at this snippet from the Legends Arceus website. Pokémon blessed with a mysterious power. There are special Pokémon in the Hisui region that have received a mysterious blessing. Some of these Pokémon, known as Nobles, are particularly powerful, while others are said to willingly assist the people of the region. Your encounters with these special Pokémon will be a key part of your story. I want to point out something that I think is extremely important in the wording of this quote. Some of these Pokémon, known as Nobles, are particularly powerful, while others are said to willingly assist the people of the region. This single sentence changes everything we know about these special Pokémon. Let me explain. Special Pokémon are divided into two groups, nobles and those that are willing to assist humans. Here's another piece of information from the website. The wardens who serve the special Pokémon. The people of the Hisui region hold a great respect for these special Pokémon and task wardens to look after them. The wardens protect the special Pokémon by making sure their territories remain safe and by providing offerings of food and water. So, while Kleavor is a noble Pokémon, and Weirdeer, Basque Legion, and Hisuian Bravery assist the people of the Hisui region, they all have wardens that look after them. Like it said, they take care of these special Pokémon by giving them food and water and making sure that the areas they live in remain safe. We'll talk about both of these groups, nobles and assistants, but first, let's talk about the noble Pokémon, since there's only one that we know of right now. Cleaver's warden is Leon, and he appears to be related to Clay from the Unova region. His hat is extremely similar to Leon's, and they have the same eye color and hairstyle. Another thing to note about Leon's appearance is that he is covered in dirt, and Clay is the ground-type gym leader. Just something interesting I noticed while poring over the information for this game. Anyways, the website has this to say about Leon. Leon cares for Kleavor, the lord of the Obsidian Fieldlands. Though young, he has been given the role of a warden because he has proven himself to be very talented. Here, we can see that Leon does indeed take care of Kleavor's territory, and that he got this position because of his talents, despite his young age. This means he gives food and water to Kleavor and makes sure it is healthy. We also see that this particular Kleavor has a noble title, the Lord of the Obsidian Fieldlands. We have seen Kleavor's level in trailers, and because his level is so low, I think he'll be the first boss Pokémon we have to fight. I would also like to point out that we know that these noble Pokémon are extremely powerful. But how many of these noble Pokémon are there? Looking at this picture of the Pokédex, we can see here the symbol for the Obsidian Fieldlands, and grayed out beside it are four more symbols. This means there are at least four more locations to explore. So perhaps there are four more noble Pokémon, all of which are frenzied and need to be calmed down. We'll talk about the map some other time, but for now, let's talk about how to calm these frenzied noble Pokémon. First of all, what are frenzied noble Pokémon? Basically, a strange phenomenon is causing nobles to suddenly fly into a frenzy, making them incredibly difficult to rein in. As part of the Survey Corps, you will be called upon to quell the frenzies of the nobles. This means we don't know what made them go into a frenzy, but it's our job to calm them down. This may also lead into a questline where we find the source that is making the nobles fly into a rage. Hey everyone, this is Editing Rav, and Recording Rav made a mistake in his script. There were a couple images from the trailers that I'm going to show right now and read that I missed while I was making the script for this video. So I'm going to insert this in, but just know that this is unscripted. Leon says in this image, "And you, I've already deduced that you've come here to meet Kleavor. I'm right, aren't I?" And then the next picture he says, "But even a loyal warden like myself can't get close enough to give any offerings now. Not with the way Kleavor is rampaging and running amok." And then, almost the exact next scene later in the trailer, we see Commando give us this mission. "This is your mission now, Rey." Rey is the player character's name for these games. "I order you to study Kleavor and help us find the truth of this situation." So we do have a quest line to figure out what has happened to Kleavor, as well as calming him down. Okay, back to the scripted Rav now. Let's talk about how to quell the frenzied Pokemon. The bodies of frenzied Pokemon grow in size and shine brightly. Simply defeating these Pokemon in a Pokemon battle will not calm them. To quell them, you will need to hit them with bombs made using these noble Pokemon's favorite foods. While defeating the nobles in battle might not quell the frenzied Pokemon, it will help you immensely in calming them down as seen here. Use Pokemon battles to your advantage. While nobles are formidable opponents, defeating them in the battle will cause them to be temporarily dazed, making it easier for you to hit them with more bombs and gain the upper hand. Now, let's talk about bombs. A balm is, by definition, a fragrant cream or liquid used to heal or soothe the skin. In this instance, it is indeed used to soothe the noble Pokemon. You might be wondering, what's in the balm? The answer is that it is made from the Pokemon's favorite foods, which, thankfully, the wardens, Leon in this case, will know exactly what Cleaver's favorite food is. It's literally his job. Perhaps we will have to go out and collect these nobles' favorite food and then craft the bombs before going to fight them. This is speculation on my part, since that hasn't been told to us. Once you get to the battle, we have to dodge attacks and throw bombs. It won't be easy to hit a rampaging noble with bombs. They will relentlessly unleash powerful attacks at you. The moment you see an opening, hit them with as many bombs as you can. Just like with throwing a Pokeball, aim carefully. As we battle the noble Pokemon, we have to dodge their attacks and throw bombs at them. Getting them into Pokemon battles and defeating them will stun them for a short time. So battling them a lot to land bombs might be a good idea. Let's look at some images from the fight with Kleavor to see what we can learn from them. Here, we can see the opening of the fight with Kleavor. His actual title is the Lord of the Woods, which is fitting because he can chop down trees easily. We can also see his name in large text below that, and behind that is the Arceus ring thing? I don't know what to call this. We can also see that Kleavor is glowing yellow and orange, showing that he is currently in a frenzy. We see the player dodging and failing to dodge a lot of attacks. We see some scenes where they are battling the Kleavor, and other scenes where they are throwing bombs, which are called forest bombs. We can also see that this long yellow bar along the top of the screen. I'm going to call this the frenzy gauge, because I'm assuming it goes down a set amount every time you manage to hit it with a bomb. When the gauge goes down all the way, perhaps Kleavor will no longer be in a frenzy. We also see that the ZL button is held down to focus. I'm assuming this is to zoom in, and then you throw the bombs with X, and the Y button is used to dodge attacks. Just like other wild Pokemon, you will black out if Kleavor hits you too much. Now, let's talk about the other special Pokemon, the ones that aren't nobles, the ones that are willing to assist humans. As of right now, this includes Weirdeer, Basculegion, and Braviary. We'll start with Weirdeer. Mai is in charge of caring for a special Weirdeer that can be found in the Obsidian Fieldlands. She and her partner Munchlax grew up together as if they were siblings. Here, we can see that Weirdeer is also found in the Obsidian Fieldlands, so perhaps we will unlock the ability to ride Weirdeer pretty soon in the game. I don't think we have to battle or calm down Weirdeer, or the other Pokemon that are willing to assist humans, because they aren't frenzied, and nothing on the website shows that we would have to battle them. They just like helping humans. Next is Basculegion. Iscan is a warden that lives by the sea and cares for a special Basculegion that makes its home in the area. He can be a bit easy to frighten and isn't too fond of ghost-type Pokemon. We don't see the location where we unlock Basculegion on the website. All we know is that we might unlock it when we get to a map that has the sea by it. He also seems to be afraid of ghost Pokemon, and yet Basculegion is a water ghost-type. Perhaps he doesn't know Basculegion is a ghost-type? This is unclear as of right now. The last special Pokemon that assists humans that we know of is Hisuian Braviary, but we don't know the warden that is watching it. We have seen another warden named Aruzu, but all we know about her Pokemon is that it is listed as a certain lady Pokemon. Based on this, I am going to assume that Aruzu's special Pokemon is a noble Pokemon. Lady is the female equivalent of a lord, which was used as a noble title in the past. I could be wrong about this, as it's just a guess based on the wording. Another thing to point out about special Pokemon that help humans is that we call them by playing the Celestica flute. Here's what the website says about it. Riding Pokemon across untamed landscapes. During your adventure, you'll receive a Celestica flute. You can play the flute to summon special Pokemon that will let you ride them. Riding these Pokemon on land, across water, or even through the skies will help you more freely explore the Hisui region. Based on my earlier assumption that we get access to riding Weirdeer early in our adventure, we will also get the Celestica flute early as well. Based on these scenes, we can see that you press the plus button to summon whatever mount you may need. The biggest piece of information to take away from this video is that while all noble Pokemon are special, not all the special Pokemon are nobles. We will probably only battle the nobles, while the other special Pokemon willingly help us. What do you think about these special Pokemon? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Peace.